And now, Dick Tracy.
This is Dick Tracy. Stand by for action. Let's go, men. Yes, it's Dick Tracy, protector of law and order. Boys and girls, aside from the actual trees destroyed in forest fires, can you think of what else is destroyed? Well, fires destroy the life-giving qualities in the soil besides killing the seeds that would ordinarily grow into more trees. They kill the wildlife that's part of every forest, the birds, animals like deer, squirrels, rabbits, chipmunks, and many, many others. Think of this. If there were nothing but forests in the states of Connecticut, Delaware, Massachusetts, New Hampshire, New Jersey, Rhode Island, and Vermont, and all those forests were destroyed, there wouldn't be as much as was destroyed by fire in just the year 1943. No country, not even the United States, can afford to lose that much lumber. And 70% of the fires were caused by human carelessness. Now here's what you can do to help prevent fires when you're out in the woods. After using a match, blow it out, break it in two, pinch the burnt end until you're sure it's dead. You can be certain the match will be harmless because you won't care to pinch a burnt end while it's still hot. And make sure you put out any fire you might build before you leave it. In this way, you'll do your part in conserving our forest. And now, Dick Tracy.
I walked out onto the center of the stage and called to the stage manager.
Vitamin.
I said to him, "Me good man, I know the line. What is the name of the play we are doing?"
Vitamin.
Yes, me love?
Tracy is asleep, dear.
Asleep? Gad, do you mean to say that I've been telling that story to myself all this time?
You didn't seem to mind, darling.
Oh, yes, I didn't, did I? What? Tracy, old man, wake up. Wake up. What's up?
You, Tracy, you've been asleep.
Oh, I'm sorry. What time is it?
Half after two, old man.
Oh, good heavens. I've got an early conference with the fire commissioner in the morning. I've got to run. May I have my coat and hat, Vitamin?
Of course, old man. I'll get it for you.
Well, I had a nice time at your party, Snowflake.
Oh, even if you did fall asleep.
Well, I'm sorry, Snowflake. But that series of fires we've been having in the city lately has kept me going day and night. You see, we suspect they're more than accidents.
Here's your hat and coat, old fellow.
Oh, thanks, Vitamin. Well, you're a wonderful cook, Snowflake.
Oh.
Well, thanks again for asking me over to dinner. Good night.
Oh, the telephone. Pardon me. This is the Flintheart apartment. Flintheart speaking.
Hi, Flint. Let me speak to Tracy, will you?
Why, Gravel Gertie.
Who'd you think it was, Greer Garson? Let me speak with Tracy. They told me he was at your flat.
Why, yes, he is, Gertie. Hold on, I'll get him. It's for you, old man. Gravel Gertie. Here.
Oh, thanks, Vitamin. Hello, Gertie.
Look, Tracy, I've been trying to call you ever since the big fire started.
Big fire? Where?
Over here on River Street, 101, where all those warehouses is.
Well, how long has it been burning?
About a half hour, Tracy. It looks pretty bad. I got an idea. Everything ain't strictly on the up and up, see? I'm worried that my junkyard will burn up and...
Well, don't tell me about it over the phone. I'll be right over.
Yes, I know there have been a great many fires down in the warehouse district, old man. But what makes you suspect foul play?
Fires like that don't just happen, Vitamin. There's some reason behind all this.
Did you hear that, Tracy? You must be getting close.
Look at the sky up ahead, Vitamin.
Degad, hadn't noticed. The fire makes it as bright as midday.
Vitamin, 6 people have died since those fires started. I'd like to get my hands on the one who's causing them.
Oh, I see, old man. Isn't that a woman standing in the middle of the street just ahead up there?
Why, yes. It's Gravel Gertie. Stop the car, Vitamin. Gertie! Gravel Gertie!
Is that you, Tracy? I've been waiting here for you.
Oh, what is it, Gertie?
I think I got an idea about why them fires are being started, Tracy.
You have?
Yeah. You see that shack? Well, that's mine. And you see that yard piled high with scraps and junk? Well, that's also mine. Just read that there sign up there, will you?
Gravel Goethe, dealer in junk and factory scraps. I buy and sell anything.
You're in business?
Yeah, Tracy, and I'm doing okay, see?
Factory scraps and junk.
What's the matter with it, Flinthead?
Nothing at all, me dear woman.
Then shut up, and stop making with the raised eyebrow department.
Well, what did you want to tell me, Gertie? I want to get over the fire.
Well, this. Some guy wants to get this here place away from me.
I can't understand why.
Look, Flint Brain, I told you before to shut up. Now you're going to do it or will I have to give you a hit in the head?
Sorry. Well, come on, Gertie. Tell us the story.
Well, this here guy comes around about a month ago and he asked me if I want to sell my lease. He wants to buy up the property around here, see?
Go on.
I tell him I ain't interested. And then he gets sore.
Yes?
First he offers more money. Then he starts making with a threat.
Well, what did he say? Like what?
Like he was going to have this here piece of property or else, that he needed it. Also, he says he needs some other property along the river here where the warehouses is, and he's going to get hold of that, too. That he had ways to get it.
I see. What's his name?
Oh, wait now. I got his card here. Yeah, I got it in my pocket. Now, let me see. Oh, yeah, here it is.
J.P. Doom, Real Estate, 209 River Street. Why, that's only a block or two from here. J.P. Doom. I know that name.
I don't quite follow all this, old man. Do you suspect this Doom person of setting the fire?
I don't know yet, Vitamin. There's that possibility. He's a shady character, mixed up in politics.
What could he hope to gain by getting this property, old sleuth?
Boy, Flint, top of you, then. Look, there's been so many fires around this here neighborhood, you can't get insurance no more. Property owners is getting scared. So they sell out at this guy Doom's price. So he gets what he wants.
And what he wants is that river property. You know, Vitamin, there's a rumor afoot that the city is going to put the new superhighway through here.
Well, in that case, Doom will be able to name his own price and get it.
Are you going to the fire now, Tracy?
No, Gertie. We're going to investigate the office of J.P. Doom.
Come away from that window, Hartfoot. Stop watching that fire.
Not watch it. It's beautiful. Beautiful. And it's mine. I made it.
You know, Doom, I think he enjoys watching them fires. We make more than the money you pay us to make them.
Listen, you. I don't want to hear you say that.
Well, why not? It's true, ain't it?
Don't say it. Suppose someone were to hear you.
At 3 o'clock in the morning in your office? Why, there ain't nobody in this here building at this hour.
Just the same, don't say it.
They'll never stop it. It'll burn and burn and burn until there's nothing left.
Listen, Hartfoot, you should never have come back here to my office. Suppose you've been seen.
Nobody ever sees me make my fires, Doom. I am an artist. The fires don't start till Gimmick and I are out of the neighborhood at least 1 hour.
Yeah. I gotta hand that to you, Hotfoot. You got the alibi angle worked out fine.
That's because I'm smart. Smart. Well, Doom, what next? What do we burn tomorrow night?
Nothing.
Nothing? But you...
We're laying low for a few weeks. The police have been snooping around this district like a pack of bloodhounds.
They'll never catch me. I'm too clever for him.
No. Look, Hotfoot. I think Doom's right. Take it easy for a while till the heat's on.
Don't forget, Tracy's working on this case.
Tracy. I'd like to match wits with Dick Tracy.
Yeah? Well, I wouldn't.
Someone knocked.
Yeah. How did anyone know we was here? The light's out.
Not the light from my fire. It lights up the whole city.
He's trying to unlock the door. Who's there?
Open up in there.
Go in the other office. You can slip out the other door after he comes in here. Close the door quietly.
Right. Come on.
All right, I'm coming.
Yeah?
J.P. Doom?
Yeah. What do you mean by trying to break into my office?
I'm Dick Tracy of the police. I thought I saw some men come in here. Thought I'd investigate.
Oh. I say. Come in, Mr. Tracy, come in.
Oh, thanks. Come in, Vitamin, and shut the door.
Right-o, old screw.
There's no one here but me, Mr. Tracy.
Rather late to be at your office, Mr. Doom, isn't it?
Why, yes, Mr. Tracy, but when I heard there was another fire down here, I came right over.
Like fires, Mr. Doom?
Like them? Well, I know, Mr. Tracy, but you see, I own considerable property down here.
And you're trying to buy more?
Yeah. Anything criminal in that, Mr. Tracy?
Depends on the method you use, me fine fella.
Vitamin.
But, Tracy, Gravel Gertie said he made threats.
Vitamin, let me handle this.
Oh, yes, quite proceed, old man.
Well, Mr. Doom, you heard what Mr. Flintheart said.
I assure you, Mr. Tracy, I never threatened Gravel Gertie. I tried to purchase a lease, yes, but that's all.
Well, Mr. Doom, it's your word against hers. But I'm going to get to the bottom of this whole business.
Surely you don't suspect me of having anything to do with these terrible fires.
I don't know, Mr. Doom. I don't know yet. But I'm going to find out. Come on, Vitamin.
Right behind you, Tracy, old tracer.
Oh, by the way, Doom.
Yeah?
Perhaps you've heard the rumor that the city is putting the new superhighway through that property you've been trying to buy up. Could that have anything to do with the fires?
Yeah. Gravel Gertie, huh? Huh?
Who's there?
Don't get excited. It's us, Hotfoot and Gimmick.
I thought you'd gone.
Well, Hotfoot wanted to hear what Tracy had to say, so we listened.
It's just as well you didn't go, boys.
Oh, yeah.
Remember, I said no fires for a while?
Yeah.
Well, that's out.
I know. You want to get rid of Tracy, right?
Yeah. But first, we've got to get rid of Gravel Gertie. It would be a most unfortunate accident if...
Her place would burn down. Yes.
It would be most unfortunate if her place would burn down with her in it.
Let's return to Dick Tracy and the Case of the Firebug Murders.
Mess. And I'll never see my Nellie anymore. A man's wake from sun to sun. A woman's wake is never done. Ain't it the truth? Now, who can that be? At this time of night, too. Well, don't get in an uproar. I'm coming.
Oh, hello, Gertie.
Well, Snowflake. Come on in, dearie. Come in. I wasn't expecting no visitors. You see, I was just about ready to hit the hay. Ain't this shack a mess?
Gertie, have you seen Vitamin this evening?
Vitamin? No. Him and Tracy was here last night, but
then you haven't seen him.
Not tonight, I ain't. Tracy was around the neighborhood this afternoon, looking around, but your husband wasn't with him.
Oh, dear.
Well, what's the matter, dearie? Worried?
Went out after lunch to see his agent, he said. And here it is 11 o'clock at night, and I haven't heard a word from him.
Now, ain't that just like a man? Well, what made you think he was here?
He told me that he and Tracy had been here to see you last night.
And you think he's with Tracy tonight, huh?
I don't know, Gertie. I don't know. I tried to reach Tracy, but he wasn't at his office.
Say, maybe that's him now. Just a minute, dearie. Yeah?
Hello, Gertie. Remember me?
Oh, remember? How could I forget my best customer? Come in.
Come on in, Gimme.
Yeah.
Now, what can I do for you, Stoogen? The regular order? 15 pounds of magnesia scrap?
Yeah, Gertie. That's right, huh, Hotfoot?
No, Gimme. Hmm? We want a double order tonight.
Double?
Yeah.
Okay. I got at least a ton of that stuff. Bought it from that small parts factory. Oh, I beg your pardon. This is Mrs. Flintheart. This is two customers of mine, Hotfoot and Gimmick.
How do you do?
How do you do?
I'll get the scraps for you. I got them back here.
Did you say Flintheart?
Yes. Do you know my husband?
Know him, Mrs. Flintheart.
We don't know him, Mrs. Flintheart, but, as a matter of fact, we nearly met him last night. Didn't we, Gimmick?
Yeah, he was with Tracy.
Oh, you haven't seen him this evening.
No, lady, we ain't seen him, but we'd like to.
Oh.
Fine gents, you thou, letting a lady lug a heavy box like this without trying to help her.
Oh, sorry, Gertie, here. Let Gimmick take that.
Yes.
Too late now. Well, there you start. 30 pounds of magnesia scrap. Now, that'll be, let me see. 25 cents a pound, 4 goes into 15, and carry the 1, $6.35.
Okay, Gertie. Give her the money, Gimmick.
Say, by the way, what do you use this here stuff for?
We treat this with special chemicals to set fires.
Oh, sure, to set fires. Why didn't I know? What?
Sure, Gertie. We set all the fires in this neighborhood.
Oh.
Why, you dirty so-and-sos. I'm going out and call Dick Tracy on the payphone and tell him.
He ain't gonna go on out and leave this here shack, Gertie.
He's got a gun.
That's right. Okay, Gimmick. Tie him up.
Oh, you ain't gonna get away with this when I tell Dick Tracy.
You're not gonna tell anyone anything again, Gertie. Because we're going to shut you up forever.
Oh.
Police headquarters, Tracy speaking.
Oh, Tracy, old man, found you at last. I've been trying to get you for the last 20 minutes.
Well, I just got back to my office, Vitamin. What is it?
Snowflake's not at the apartment.
What happened? She go home to Mother?
Oh, no, nothing like that. She thought I was with you and went out to find us. I've been with me theatrical agent all day. I forgot to call her and tell her.
Well, she'll be home soon, Vitamin. Good night. I'm going home and get some rest.
Wait a minute, Tracy. She's gone to Gravel Gertie's shack. Left me a note saying that.
Gravel Gertie's.
I'm worried, old man. Remember you told me last night that you were going to keep a watch on Gertie's place for fear J.P. Doom would try to get even with her for telling you...
About his threats. It completely slipped my mind. I've been so busy today.
Do you think there's any danger, old man?
I'm afraid maybe there is, Vitamin.
Well, what shall I do, Tracy? My poor dear wife is there.
Vitamin, meet me in front of your hotel in 5 minutes. We're going to Gravel Gertie's. And I hope we won't be too late.
No answer, old sleuth. Do you think she's home?
Well, there seems to be some sort of light inside.
Can't see anything through the window. It's too sooty.
Well, stand back, Vitamin. I'm going to crack that door open. Once more ought to do the trick.
Well, I don't see... Good heavens! Look, Tracy, Snowflake and Gertie bound and gagged. Oh, my darling little wife.
Get the gags off them, Vitamin. I'll put that candle out. We didn't get here a minute too soon. Those magnesium scraps would have caught fire and then...
Hear me, love. Now you can speak.
Ah. Oh, Vitamin. Vitamin.
Oh, come on, Mrs.
Miller. Oh, yes. Take the gag out of Gertie's mouth, Vitamin, darling.
Oh, yes, of course, me love. There.
Tracy, them rats was trying to kill us. They tied us up, then they was going to...
Wait a minute, Gertie. Wait a minute. Not so fast. Who tied you up and who wanted to kill you?
Them two rats, Hotfoot and Gimmick. They come in here and then they shot us.
Then they what?
Reach,
Tracy.
That's them, Tracy.
No, don't turn around, Tracy. Just stand there and keep your hands up. That's right. Okay, Gimmick. Looks like we got them all.
Yeah, Doom won't have nothing to worry about now.
You see, Tracy, we were waiting across the street to see whether the women would be able to escape. Then we saw you and Flintheart drive up, and we couldn't pass up that golden opportunity, could we?
So it is J.P. Doom, eh?
That's right, Tracy. But now you'll never be able to bother him again. Or us either. Get his gun, Gimmick.
Right, Hotfoot.
Oh, sure, sure. Now you...
He's got hold of me, Hotfoot. Hey,
we'll stop that.
Oh, Tracy.
Tracy, he's down.
Oh, dear.
Tracy thought he'd try something, did he? Okay, Gimmick. Now tie them all up good.
Yeah. You want the gags again?
No. No gags. They can yell all they want to now. It will all be over very soon. No one will hear them.
Tracy, my dear, I can't see him. They have me tied to this chair and I'm facing the other way.
He's still unconscious, Vitamin. Tracy. Tracy, please wake up, Tracy.
If I ever get out of this here place alive, I'm going to make them two rats rich they were never born.
The candle is rapidly running out. Or is it the sands of time?
Tracy. Tracy.
That there candle's getting mighty low. Close to that there magnesia.
Out, out, brief candle. Life is but a walking shadow. A poor player who struts and frets his weary hour upon the stage and then is heard no more.
Ah, shut up. Ain't it bad enough to have to die? Do you have to make with a torture, too?
Why, me good woman, I was quoting.
Tracy, he's waking up.
Oh, my head.
Tracy, Tracy.
Oh, where am I?
We're all here in Gertie's shack.
Tied up, waiting for the end, old man.
What's that?
In a moment, the candle will ignite the magnesium scraps, and then we...
Oh, I've got to get these ropes off my hands.
Tracy, it's no use. We've been trying to get our own ropes off for the last 20 minutes while you were unconscious.
Yeah, can't be did, Tracy.
In my language, there's no such word as can't.
It's impossible, old friend.
Well, I certainly did a good job. We've got to get out of here before that candle burns.
I've got it.
Got what, old Houdini? I wonder if I can roll over to the candle.
Tracy, what are you going to do?
I'm going to try to burn the ropes off my hands by holding them over the candle flame.
Good idea, Tracy. But careful with the candle. If it gets knocked over into them scraps, this place will go up so fast we won't know what happened.
I've got to take that chance.
Got it yet, old smoke eater?
There. Now.
Oh, hurry, Tracy, hurry. The candle's so low. The stuff will catch fire in a minute.
Come on. Burn through. Burn through. The ropes have got to burn through.
Why doesn't it burn? Why doesn't it burn? I thought you said the shack would burn down in about 20 minutes. What's taking so long?
It will. Don't be impatient. It should go up in about 30 seconds. Come over here to the back window of the office and see it happen.
No. I don't want to see it.
You come over here, Gimmick. Come on. It'll make quite a sight.
No, I don't want to see it either.
The candle is very short, and what a blaze it will make. The shack is full of oily waste rags and magnesium scraps. It'll be the biggest blaze I've ever set.
Come away from that office window. Someone might see you.
What are you so nervous about, Doom? You're getting everything just the way you want tonight. Tracy and the others out of the way. And now you're in the clear.
What about my conscience?
Conscience? Have you got a conscience?
Oh, no, cut it out. This ain't no time to argue. We all gotta hang together now. We're in pretty deep.
Hang together?
Yeah.
What an unpleasant way of putting it. But don't think you can get rid of us, J.P., we're going to stick around.
Gosh, look at the sky.
Huh?
It's all lit up. The shack's caught fire.
Huh? Yes. Come on, let's watch it from the window.
Yeah. Hey, look at it burn.
Well, that's the end of Dick Tracy, boys. He'll never bother us again.
All right. Tracy. All of you.
Tracy.
Keep your hands up, Doom. You too, Hotfoot. Come on in, Vitamin. Right, old fire eater. Take their guns away while I keep them covered. Yes, Tracy, old man. Well, what are you laughing at, Hotfoot?
I just remembered something, Tracy. Something very funny. You can take your hand out of your coat pocket. You haven't got a gun. We took it away from you.
Gad, discovered.
Now you get your hands up, Tracy. I'm boss now.
Tracy, he's got your gun.
Hey, Hotfoot, he grabbed it. Here, look out.
Why, you...
Watch out, old man! Oh!
Two down and one to go!
Stop! I give up!
Okay, Mr. Doom. Okay. Vitamin?
Yes, old slugger. What a battle, old man. Hotfoot and Gimmick out in two punches. What a battle.
All right, get on the phone, Vitamin. Call headquarters. Tell them to send a trap over here to pick up three rats.
Righto! We did it again, didn't we, old gumshoe?
Yes, I guess we did, Vitamin. The next time these boys come in contact with anything hot, it'll be the chair in the death house of the state prison.